Okay, so before we move on to a study of higher order differential equations, it's useful to look at some special kinds of first order ODEs, right, which can be, you know, with the help of some transformations cast into a separable form, right? So if it is linear, of course we know how to do it, but you know, there are more general first order ODEs which are important, which appear in applications and which, you know, look apparently difficult to solve, but there are, you know, some clever transformations using which they can be you know, made separable, right? So that's the subject for this lecture. Okay, so you know, one class of equations which are first order, right, which are nonlinear, right, clearly is, you know, they go by the name of the Bernoulli equation. So the Bernoulli equation is of this kind: dy by dx plus some function of x times y is equal to q of x times y to the n, right? So clearly, because there is y to the n, it's a nonlinear equation. It's first order because dy by dx is all there is, no higher order. But this can be recast into a familiar form if you just make this transformation. You write down z is equal to y to the power 1 minus n, then it, you can make it linear in z. So what happens is, so dz by dx is equal to 1 minus 1 minus n times y to the minus n dy by dx, right? So you plug that in, and then you know, in place of y to the right, so you have to substitute throughout, and in place of y you put it in terms of z and so on, and there will be this cancellations of all these y to the minus n's. They cancel out nicely, and then you're left with dz by dx plus 1 minus n times p times z is equal to 1 minus n times q. So now this is a familiar differential equation. It's not only first order, but it's also linear, right, in z. And so then we can go ahead and solve it, right? So this is one class of problems which apparently look difficult, but which can be solved using the methods that we already are aware of, provided we spot the form and we make use of this, the right substitution. So let's look at another class of equations which can also be solved. And so these are called homogeneous equations, not to be confused with, you know, the term homogeneous we used earlier to refer to, you know, equations where the right hand side was zero, right? So that's one kind of terminology, but homogeneous equations are also equations involving homogeneous functions. A function is homogeneous and with degree n if it can be written as x to the n times f of y by x, right? So basically the function cannot be an arbitrary function of x and y, but there must be a way to, you know, treat this as a function of y by x. You should be able to, so the powers of y and the powers of x in every term, right, must conspire in such a way that f of y by x, there's a meaningful way of thinking of this as a function of y by x, right? So let's look at a few examples. So if you have something like, you know, all the you know, these equations are all homogeneous equations, x squared minus 5xy. So you have, you know, the power here is 2, x times y, you know, 1 plus 1 is again 2, and then y cubed by x, again it's, you know, effective power, or here is also 2. So you know, one way to see this explicitly is to pull out x squared, and so you see that the first term becomes 1, the second term will become minus 5y by x, and the third term will become y by x the whole cube. So, and indeed you see that this is a, you know, a function of this form. And the second one is also a homogeneous equation, because here you can pull out y to the 4, and then you get x cubed by y cube, 1 minus x cubed by y cube, and you know, you can think of this as so, and then you also have this second term, xy squared is there, but which you can write it as y, if you pull out a y cube, then it becomes x by y, right? So the first equation is x inverse y to the 4, and then you have the second equation, which is y cube times x by y. So y to the 4 divided by x, so y by x, so y cube, you know, you can pull out again out of the entire equation. So you have y by x, and here you have, if you pull out y cube, you have x by y, right? So it's doesn't matter whether it appears as x by y or as y by x. You can convince yourself that this indeed works out here as well. And then the third equation also, it will work out. You can check that indeed you can write this equation as so if I pull out x to the power phi from this equation, so it's y by x the whole cube comes in here. So and indeed there's an x to the power phi which comes in here, so which will go with, you know, y power phi divided by x to the power phi, and then there's an overall y which comes to the denominator, and indeed third equation also works out. So you have to check this. Sometimes it looks deceptive, but in fact you can convince yourself with a little bit of effort that it's a homogeneous equation. And then to contrast, let's look at a few examples where they are not homogeneous. So no matter what you do, you cannot bring it to this form, right? X squared plus y is one such example. X plus cos of y is another. Xy plus x is another such example, right? So you know, homogeneous equations are very special, right? And when an equation is homogeneous, right, an equation of this form, you say is homogeneous if p, you know, there are these two functions p of x comma y and q of x comma y. If both p of x comma y and q of x comma y are homogeneous functions of the same degree, right? So then you say that this whole equation is homogeneous. So then it's a very special form. Then it turns out that you can write dy by dx as f of y by x, and if this is possible, then there is a way to, you know, at least formally solve this differential equation, no matter how crazy this f is, right? So you can just make the substitution y is equal to x times v, and then you can solve for it. So let's look at an example to make this concrete. So if I have x plus y times dx minus x minus y dy equal to 0, clearly this is a homogeneous equation, because x plus y and x minus y are both homogeneous functions and both of them have the same degree, right? So the degree is this, you know, this power n. So you can immediately see that both of them have the same degree in this case. And so if you make the substitution y equal to xv, so then we have dy by dx is equal to x times dv by dx plus v. If we go ahead and substitute for this, so we have x dv by dx plus v. That's dy by dx. So dy by dx must be equal to x plus y divided by x minus y, but which can be written as 1 plus v divided by 1 minus v. And then you can just bring all the terms involving v to the left hand side and all the terms involving x to the right hand side. So the x part is very easy. You just get dx by x on the right hand side, and the left hand side you get 1 minus v divided by 1 plus v squared. So you write it as two separate terms, 1 over 1 plus v squared minus v over 1 plus v squared. The first of this will just integrate to tan inverse of v, and the second one of them will give you minus half log of 1 plus v squared. You can check this and convince yourself that this holds, which is equal to log of x plus c. So the solution is given by, so now you have to go back and plug in. For in place of v you have y by x, then you have, you know, this gives you square root of 1 plus y squared by x squared, which you can write it as x squared plus y squared by x squared. So so log x minus log x will cancel with you know, minus times minus log x will cancel with this log x on the right hand side. And so basically your final answer will be just tan inverse of y by x is equal to log of square root of x squared plus y squared plus an overall constant. So there are other clever change of variables, which are, you know, very special to special forms, there are a couple of special cases which we will look at, right? And maybe there'll be some homework looking at other kinds of change of variables which allow. So type one is, if you have a differential equation of the form dy by dx is equal to some function of ax plus by plus c on the right hand side. So even if the function which appears on the right hand side is a very complicated function, if it is has this integrity, right, which is, you know, this particular form, then you can just make the substitution z is equal to ax plus by plus c, and then dz by dx becomes a plus b times dy by dx, which is the same as a plus b times f of z. So the right hand side, you know, so your differential equation in z is just dz by dx equal to a plus b times f of z. So you can separate terms and bring all the terms in z to the left hand side and all the terms in x to the right hand side, which is dx. So if you are able to do this integral, which may not always be possible, integral of dz by a plus b times f of z, then you're done, right? And then of course you have to go back and plug in for z in the final, you know, final solution, and then you have a solution for y itself, which may not be easy to write down in closed form, but at least there is a formal solution available for differential equations of this form. Now there's another type where you may have a, you know, the right hand side is not this simple function of ax plus by plus c, but it may be a function of this form f of ax plus by plus c divided by dx plus ey plus f. Now if this happens, you can actually make this homogeneous with the help of a substitution of this type, where x, in place of x you write z minus h, and in place of y you write w minus k. You shift these variables by an amount which we will see what that should be. So we demand that if you make the substitution, right, so your ax plus by plus c divided by dx plus ey plus f now becomes az plus bw plus c minus ah minus bk over dz plus ew plus f minus dh minus ek. So we don't want these constant terms. If we can somehow make these zero, both in the numerator and in the denominator, then we will get a homogeneous form for the right hand side. So if we can somehow arrange ah plus bk equal to c and dh plus ek equal to f, then we would accomplish our goal. But we know that this is a system of equations in h and k, which has a unique solution provided this determinant ae minus bd is non-zero, right? So that's the condition. If ae minus bd is non-zero, then for sure there is this transformation which can make your right hand side homogeneous, and then we know how to solve, right? So we have seen the prescription for that. But on the other hand, if ae is a minus bd is equal to zero, so it's not a problem. If it is, then this problem is actually a type 1 problem, right? You see the numerator and denominator. So what does ae minus bd equal to 0 mean? It means that, you know, when you have something like this, a function of this kind, so you have a plus ax plus by in the numerator, but you have dx plus ey in the denominator, can be thought of as some eta times ax plus by, right? Of course there is c and f, but basically you can just substitute for ax plus by. You can make the substitution z is equal to ax plus by, and then it's separable formally at least, right? So we'll give you some homework where, you know, so there'll be some example problems where you'll have to work this out. But the idea is that a differential equation dy by dx is equal to some function of this complicated looking expression can also be solved formally, right? If this determinant ae minus bd is non-zero, then you homogenize using this prescription. On the other hand, if it is zero, then you just make the substitution z is equal to ax plus by and solve it like we did earlier, right? So the main message from this lecture is that, you know, when for first order equations which have a certain special form, even if it is non-linear, there are these nice, you know, substitutions which may be possible, some transformations which can recast this problem into a form from where we know how to solve this problem. Okay, that's all for this lecture. Thank you.